Good morning, y'all.
It's a new day today.
Got this fire-ass Harley racing jacket on. Today is an event that I usually do. I've done these every single time for like the past 3 or 4 years, but with just everything going on, I didn't have time to really dedicate a whole week to getting stuff ready, priced, getting my car packed up. And so, you know, I was like, you know what, today they're painting, I have a gap day, so I'm going to go shop it. I'm gonna film it, show you guys kind of, this is one of the better vintage events in Indiana. So I'm gonna show you guys kind of my cops, some of the vendors there, some of my buddies. Just say what's up and show a little love to those guys, show their Instagram and stuff so you guys can check them out. But yeah, pretty good event, I'm really excited. So yeah, let's just get to it. We're gonna be strapped up with the GoPro today. So it should be pretty fun. So yeah, let's go.
Bro, best prices, Circle City. That's crazy. Yeah, we're grabbing that for sure. What's he got in this I'm gonna be spending some money with you today. I can't wait. Can I sit these right here? Start like a little pile up. Okay. And also, can I sit this like under the chair or something? Okay. Thanks, boss.
She just had 100.
What's up, man? How are you?
Good. Question.
Yeah, yeah.
Gonna buy the whole bag for $50.
$50? What's in there?
You can look through it.
All right.
I was like, you're the guy. Everyone's been like, I don't know.
South Pole.
And I know you sell shit like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I've gotten too much inventory, way better stuff.
I get it.
That's a good one. I think it's like 90s.
Cougar International, a little leather.
Yeah. That's the greatest.
Jupiter fish.
Yeah, I don't really know. That's just a blank.
Little Toltec piece. Night ride. Oh, biker. Jerseys. Chicago, that's a cool one.
You're catching me at a bad time because we're moving right now.
Oh, really?
So I've been clearing out like a lot of my stuff. Dude, if it was any other time of the year, I would.
Dude, I'm telling you.
I got so much right now. I got so much stuff to move right now. I got like a U-Haul full of my stuff too right now.
It's
so
like
it's just,
it is.
But like literally any other event, or if I was vending, I probably would have bought it just like throwing a $5 piece. But
I completely understand.
Sorry about that, boss. I would. Oh yeah, for sure.
I'm gonna check my legs.
Sorry. I'm gonna squeeze through here so I'm gonna sit these right good sweaters here today. Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry.
Five and then ten. Panagonia, how much do I have that?
I think 35.
I'd like another 10. 25?
Oh, that's cool.
That's fine. 25? I'm not sure if I have that much price. It's reversible, so let me do... So you can reverse it.
Yeah, place. Yeah.
Let me do 15 on that one.
That's cool. That's cool. I don't think this one had a price either. On. Oh, it did. 40?
225.
That's cool.
That's fine.
Yeah. I was looking for you and I walked, and usually you're down there more, yeah. And so I was peeking, I couldn't see you.
That one, to be honest, is a little, it's a whole,
yeah.
You can do five?
Yeah, that's cool.
That's fine. Okay. 25 for the Nike one, 5 for this one. This one, do I have a price tag or not?
Oh, down there, 15 looks like.
15, do 10?
Yeah. Okay. I think you have 10 on this one. Yeah.
5.
5, okay.
Yeah. That one, to be honest, have you seen this thing?
Oh, no, no.
You might not want to take that one. What do you think?
I mean, I'll do 5 if you want to give it 5. Okay.
All right. 50. If we do both of these, I'll knock that one to 25.
And you have 70 on
70, that? 70. I'll do 40.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Perfect with all that. Best prices. All
right. Let me take care of this.
That's fine. Yeah, you're good. You're good.
Need a bag for it?
Yeah, that'll be great.
We have Cash App, Venmo, PayPal.
Venmo. Venmo. Be awesome, yeah.
And that's the link tree right there. So just scan your regular camera roll and I'll direct it.
If I grabbed like 6 or 7 sweaters, would you do 10 a piece on them?
For the knitted sweaters?
Yeah.
It depends on...
Which ones?
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
Some are priced like 35.
I got it.
For you.
Yeah, I know they little niggas like to talk, I don't really like to talk, let me pop my shit. Let me pop, I can get them haters off my, you know, I chop my nuts when I drop my shit. Let me drop. And I'm the type to keep it quiet, don't speak, they never know it's me when they pop get hit. My mama told me I should go and holler at my brother just to let him know we all be having problems and we low. It's traumatizing, you know how we started in the gut. Now I'm chilling with my daughter and damn man, she's waiting on the nigga, watching the damn camera. She cold, nigga, I'm the damn answer, beast mode. I'ma beat that damn cat, now I don't really give a fuck about how you feel. Homie, put the alphabet on him, put the AR on him, put the F and N on him, get the shooting at him. Damn dance, yeah. You know I keep the blip with the extension, never folding under pressure. No, I love it when it's tension. No, I love it when it's questions in my mind. Some f***ing mention. No, you know the BMS need some love and some attention. You be saying I'm a floater, better mother, better listen. I be switching up my floater, where I'm switching up my floater. I'm a different type of nigga, you a different type of different type. Screenshots sending out nothing to pick. Rhyme around town on another. Leaving all them comments on another. Your best friend did this, what he meant, this what he get. No, it like a shake, it's like a bit. Better go and check my background.
Oh no, we're still
open. All right, I had those up.
Okay. 10 is okay on this one. 10 is okay. This one has to do 15.
15? I'll probably pass on this one for right now.
So be 40 for these, right?
Yep.
Okay, 40 for these? Is that it? 40? Not told for you 40 on this one too, right?
Yep.
40? I think it was
25.
Okay. This one was 5.
5? Yep. Yep.
5?
Yep. 10? Yep.
We said 25, right?
Yep.
15.
Yep.
25.
Yep.
5.
Yep.
5.
Perfect. 210. Let's do it. It was 210, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And kid on the move. Go!
That's my dad.
Did you get that?
Was that on Cash App?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm a slime.
you got it,
Austin. Right on. And for everyone watching, Circle City Vintage, the best, like literally every time I come to this event, they have the best deals. Right, yeah, yeah, dude.
For the YouTube, right?
Yeah, yeah. Hey, so you guys have the best deals, best stuff, best prices, so I always appreciate it. Everyone check out their Instagram. Do you guys sell on like any platform?
So I used to sell on Depop, and I just got a little bit lazy and all.
I get it, I get it.
Consistency sometimes.
Come on, guys. I got the GoPro going today. It's you? It's all Mikey's?
That's a cool setup, though.
Dude, like, I like, because I hate when I have it on, like, at estate sales, and every old person there is, like, just eyeballing my chest the whole time.
Just sell it like you have a heart condition.
Yeah, and, like, the last time I did, this lady was like, you're the reason why there's so many kids that come to these estate sales, aren't you? And I'm like, no.
Like, I love those TikToks where you can see their POV, and I'm like, oh, I wonder what that looks like. I've never seen it.
Yeah.
Dude, you grew your channel pretty fast, though.
Yeah, like, no complaints. On, like, the last time I posted, the video only got like 600 views the first couple days, and like I was like damn, I felt like it flopped pretty hard.
I was one of the views though.
Right on, much love. I met a fan in person. Kind of saw like a little pile of stuff. I don't know where you want me to sit it. Okay. These are pretty fire.
Yeah. I didn't want to wash them though. I don't like smelling stinky clothes.
No, I get it. What was your price on that one?
Yeah, I think I was asking like 45.
45? It's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
I'm going to think on that one. Let's set these right here. I'm done for the year, dude. I'm doing like in-person events,
yeah.
But I go to Mumbai, film a little quick video.
I might go too.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too.
I think he was telling me that there was a bunch of like out of state movies.
Oh, yeah, because it's like a travel show. Do you do like?
like video work for like here?
No, I just do my own like YouTube channel. That's it. Yeah.
What's it called?
Jack Thrifts. I just started doing it like a couple months ago. And just honestly doing like trip to the thrifts type thing.
Yeah,
and estate sale hauls and stuff.
That's awesome.
I think this is my first time, because I've filmed at these before. Like, I always set up at these, but I didn't this time because I didn't have time this week to get everything ready. And tomorrow I couldn't come anyway. And so I was like, today I might as well come out and buy some stuff. Yes, sir. What's the best price you could do for this whole pile right here?
She didn't have
half the stuff is his.
Oh, okay, I got you. What's okay? First of all, I guess we can figure out like, what's yours and.
Oh, this is mine.
Okay.
This is Christian's.
Okay. How close would you be to like 80 for all that?
You said 80? Could you do 90?
Yeah, that's cool.
Just because I didn't realize this was so stayed up. So.
Oh, you're good. Yeah. You have Cash App, don't you?
No, I don't. I have a Zelle Venmo, and I just take cash.
Okay, you have PayPal either?
No.
Okay. Let me. I don't have Venmo, so. Yeah.
You can Cash App him.
Okay, that's cool.
You can Venmo me, right?
I guess if you want to, we can also figure out like what yours is too, and I can include that into the price so I don't have to cash up you like multiple times. If you just want to do like individually, and then I can kind of figure out, because I didn't see any prices on them, so I wasn't sure.
So I'd be at 25 on this.
Okay.
15?
Okay, I'll do that one for sure. Let me think on this one for a sec.
That's cool. Let me get my calculator.
Yeah, you're good.
Also 15?
Yep.
15?
And you do 10 on that one? Okay, I'll grab that one then for sure. So that's 25.
Can you do 15?
Honestly, I was on 10 on those two and then 15 on that one if you could.
So 20?
Plus 35. Yeah, so 35 for those three.
Yeah, that's...
Okay.
And, what would you want to be on?
I think my most I could do is, like, 15 on it. If you can't do that, I understand.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. So, 95 for you, 90 for you. So, 185? Okay. And here, I'll let you take those hangers off, too. What was your cash at? Did you get that? Catch up's the worst. Takes forever to update.
Yep.
Perfect. Right on, brother.
Thank you, man.
And what's your Instagram?
I got you in a bit.
Are you a hand of God?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I thought. I want people to see on YouTube so they can check out your page too. Hand of God Vintage, right on. Hand_of_God_Vintage. Cool. Right on, bro. Thank you.
Yeah.
Scrappy, nice appreciate you as always. The Scrappy Thrifts for all the YouTube people.
I'm gonna try my best to think about what I paid for everything. I bought a lot of stuff for some good buddies and homies that I've had for a long time in this. So a lot of these were like bundle deals or like my prices. So if you see the price tag, I'll just tell you what I paid for it. So first up, we got the vintage Nike. I think this is the early 2000s, late 90s Nike team. Gray tag right there, which is the pocket check. I paid 25 for that. I think I can get around 50 to 60. We got the Washington Huskies vintage crew neck, good wear, has like a good cuff distressing. I love that. I paid $15 for this one. I think I can get around 30. We got the Earthwear Planet Earth Recycle t-shirt. The quote is awesome. It just talks about how like by the year 2000, a lot of plants in Ann Arbor, a lot of animals will be extinct. It is single stitch on the anvil tag. I paid $10 for this one. Very cool shirt. I think I can get around like 25 for that, I would say, 20, 25. Everything was a double up pretty much. That's what I try to usually do, at least get a double up. This is a 2000 Metallica t-shirt. It's a really good graphic, good fade. I paid $10 for this one. We got a vintage Redhead, Earth, early 2000s Redhead camouflage hoodie. Paid $10 for that one. The NASCAR t-shirt has some good wear and fade. I paid $10 for it. This was one of my early pickups. Maybe late in the day, I may have not have grabbed this one because I could probably get around 20 bucks for it to still double up, but that's something I need right now, per se. I have a lot of NASCAR stuff. We got these Carhartts. I paid $15 for these. I think I can get around 40 for them. They have super light. They have good wear and fade to them. But yeah, he had them priced at 30. I think I bought a bunch of stuff off him and asked if he'd do like 15. He said no problem, so ended up picking these up. And honestly, no holding these up to me, these may fit. So this might be a keeper, I don't know. At least wear them once or twice. Got the 49ers Windbreaker on the early 2000s Reebok NFL tag. I paid $10 on this one. I think this one will go around for 30, I would say. 30, 25, 30. Another little $10 piece, Big Dogs, just a really thick golf crew neck there. This one is a large, looks like it fits more like a medium though, maybe like a boxy large. I paid $10 on that one, I don't know if I said that. Got the Carhartt black faded crew neck right here, just a 2000s one, nothing crazy. That one I think I can get probably like 25 for, I paid $10. The vintage Duckhead Athletics, this is another $10 piece. Right there, good tag. Just a clean white hoodie. This Taz piece, I got this for $5, which is a great price. Circle City Vintage, shout them out because they're one of my favorites at these events. I always spend hundreds of dollars at their booth, and they have really good stuff for an amazing price. They get all their stuff at the bins. This one has a couple little flaws and stuff like that, nothing too crazy. He had this priced at $10, and after like 2 hours of being there, I eventually found his booth, and this was still sitting there. So I paid $5 for it. Really nice, thick crew neck. No tag, but 90s for sure. Got this Carhartt one, just needs a little OxyClean. Paid $10 for this one. Just a nice hoodie there, XL 2000s piece. Got this Purdue crew neck. I paid $10 on this one, I believe. 10 or 15, but either way, good pickup. Purdue stuff sells really well for me for around 30 bucks. This is one of my favorites of the day. It is too small for me, but it's a medium. It's a men's medium. It fits true to size, but I wear like a large. Patagonia Cinchilla, paid $25 for this. I think I can get around 50. This Nike piece, this one needs a little bit of an OxyClean. I got it for $5 because of the stain right there. And if it doesn't come out, I may just dye this one, like a black or a brown. But yeah, $5 on that one all day. I think I can get around 20 bucks for that one, 20, 25. Vintage Purdue, this one's a reversible. So if you just wanted a blank gray crew neck, you can have that, or the other side is the Purdue graphic. I paid $15 for this one, I think, 10 or 15. Purdue stuff usually sells for $25, 30, so always pick that up. Got a bunch of these sweaters for $10. I've had a couple sweaters sell here in the past couple days, so I picked up a bunch of those for $10. I'll do that all day. This one was $5, just the Bob and Tom Q95 crew neck. Very clean. I sell those in the flea market a lot for like $15, 20. Depop, they'll sell sometimes for like $20, 25. The early 2000s Arsenal Center Swoosh Nike. I paid $10 on this one. I think I can get like $20, 25. The Purdue vintage piece. He has this for $5. Honestly, I think I can get like $25, 30 for it. So that's a nice little pickup for $5. I paid 10 on the Carhartt pants. These are really clean, good size. These are really close to my size, so I may try them on. But I usually get around $30 for Carhartt pants, and I paid $10 on those. 10 or 15, I think it was 10. Got the, actually I know it was 10 on those, so yeah, 10 bucks for those. Vintage deer crew neck, I paid 10, or crew neck sweater, paid $10 on it. Just really clean, good pattern design, good quality. Better little pattern crew or sweater there, paid 10 on those. And then another one, 10 bucks. I got a couple Colts puffers today. I think on this one I paid 30, I wanna say. This one's cool, it's got a really nice smell on the back. There, I've picked up a couple of these, and I've sold a couple of them in the past week, so had to pick that up. For 30 bucks, I can usually get around 60 to 70 on those. I got a pair, this is the first time for me having Trip NYC shorts. I've had a pair of pants that sold very fast on Depop. I think I paid 25-ish, I want to say, on these. 20-25, really good studded pair. I think I can get around 50 for them, I would say, on Depop. This was a really good price. He had it for 15, but in the bundle I just said, how about 10? Perfect for the USA 1994 tie-dye t-shirt. 15 is a really good price on that anyway. But yeah, I paid 10 off, 10 bucks on that one. I think I get around 40-ish, I would say. The vintage Nike, this one's also, shout out Scrappy Brian. I buy a lot of stuff off him at these events. He's got stuff for a really good price. Play Nike t-shirt, the vintage one. On the white tag right there, I think I paid like 10 or 15 on that one. I like this one a lot. Just a nice green. Green's kind of the color of the year. Canada, kind of reminds me of the Timberland graphic, like the Earth, Wind, and Fire Timberland. I paid 15 on this one. No problem paying 15. I think I can get around 30 for it. Got the vintage Wolf crew neck. I paid 10 bucks on this one. Just a good fade, really clean, good size too. Paid 10 bucks on this one as well. This is one I find a lot and sell a lot. I think I've sold this crew neck probably like 15 times in the past year. I just find it out in the wild quite a bit, and it always sells for like 25, 30 bucks. Then our Mickey crew neck, 25, 30 bucks on that one. I think I paid 10. Got the Cabela's long sleeve, little hunting right there. It has no tag, but early 2000s. I think I can get around 25, 30 for it, I would say. Might try it on. Looks a little boxy for me, though. Got this little True Vintage Indiana University piece. 70s, I would say. Has a lot of wear, but I paid like 10 bucks for it, so had to pick that up. The Kentucky crew neck. Paid like 5 bucks for this one, I think, because it has a couple little spots. I'm going to soak out. This one's funny, just a vintage deer. I picked up a lot of deer stuff today, but it sells really well, so. The deer camo one, Hunter's Nightmare, very nice one. I think I paid $5 or $10 for that one. This one I paid $15 for because of the color, but I can easily get around 30 bucks for this one. Just a nice, clean, Tigger green crew neck. Fox Racing, I paid $15 on this one. I think I can get around 30. Just a nice, really good fade. This one's heavily worn in, but has like no holes. Just a nice fade with a little sleeve hit. This one, when I grabbed it, I didn't realize it was cropped until like I was bundling it, which isn't a big deal. I can still sell it for like 25 bucks. I paid 10 bucks for it. Just a nice Champion Indiana crop burgundy crew neck. The Sturgis 1995. She had this for 15. I got it for 10. Just a nice one there. Single stitch. Really good fade. Another deer crew neck. Paid 10 bucks for this one. It's a good navy colorway. This was a crazy good price. I paid $25 for this. This is the Jimmy Johnson NASCAR jacket, 2006. I'm probably gonna be able to sell this for around like 75 bucks, I would say. 60 to 75 bucks. This might be my favorite pickup of the day. It's a Carhartt chore jacket. Very nice color, that beautiful tonal olive green or dark green. He had it for 70 OBO. I think he charged me 40 for it, which is a crazy good price. Circle City, again, my favorite person to shop with at these events. I found a nice little $5 pile, and these are all from that. This is just a nice Harley Davidson button-up in that green colorway. I can probably get like around 20 for that. The Witch's Brew beer tea. There's a noise outside, I don't know what that was. Just early 2000s one on the heavy cotton Gildan. I think I can get around like 20, I would say, for that one. Their Harley t-shirt, just a good tie-dye. This one will go in the flea market for like 15. I Heart Witches has a little fade spot. I can still get around like 15 for that one. And then the Hard Rock New York. Very nice, has like a little musical instrument hit on the back. I can get around 15 for that. These were the two probably pricier pieces I bought from my buddy Wes. I picked up three things from him for $100 flat. The Harley Davidson big engine, the flames with the back hit. Very clean one, no flaws at all. It's a size large. I paid technically like $40 for this one, so not a bad price. I think I can get like around 70, I would say. So not quite the double up, but just a really nice piece. I didn't pick up anything too crazy, so at the end I decided to grab a couple of nice t-shirts. Ben and Jerry's Cherry Garcia, paid $40 on this one. Very nice piece. It is on the Good Fruit of the Loom tag right there. I think I can get around 70 to 80 for that one as well. And then this is one of my favorites of the day. It was only $20. Tim Burton's Night Before Christmas. Really good time to pick this one up. It has no tag, but I don't know if it's dated. It's definitely from like the original premiere of the movie. So just a good fade, good wear to it. I need to do a little sewing on the armpit, and I paid $20 on that one. New Balance, really nice black slanted pocket pants. Have like a denim with a wide leg. I paid $20 on those. I'm gonna try those ones on, to be honest. But probably ended up selling those for like 35-ish, I would say. A nice Grateful Dead hoodie right here, 2000s one, early 2000s. On the Hanes Print Pro, I paid $15 on this one. Really nice piece from Trevor. This Ed Hardy one, another one from Trevor right here. This is an Ed Hardy Y2K piece. Smaller size, but on Depop, I can still think I can get like 30 to 40 on that. And then the last one is another Indianapolis Colts puffer right there. This one I think I paid 34. So again, I can get a nice little 50, 60 bucks for that one. But yeah, that concludes this video. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate all the love on all the videos. Subscribe if you want to. I appreciate it a lot. 1,000 subscribers. I'm doing a Tupac rap tee. It's like a tee sweatshirt giveaway for free. All you have to do is subscribe. Once we hit 1,000, my next video, I'm gonna do that giveaway. So yeah, thank you all for watching again. Comment your favorite piece I picked up. If you saw anything I left that I should have picked up, let me know. Yeah, thank you guys again. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.